The following is a lecture given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 25th of March, 1976, in Delhi, India.
Sri Bhagavan Vacha Asajjananus Nannasutastam Pragyavadhan Sabhasasi Vatasum Avatasum Sananusutan Tipanita. Our the Krishna consciousness movement, it is not something new imaginary movement. It is very old movement. At least 5,000 years ago, this Bhagavad Gita was repeated by Lord Krishna in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Before that, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, 4th chapter, Imam Vivasati Yuvam Prattavan Ahamadvayam Vivasyam Manavikrahu Manuikha Kavibravi. Krishna said to Arjuna that this science of understanding God, long, long ago, I spoke to the Sun God, Vivasyam. In the Vedic scripture, we understand that every planet is inhabited by living entities. The Sun is also one of the planets, and there are living entities. Otherwise, how Krishna could go there and speak the predominating person, Vivasyam? The name of the person is also given. Imam Vivasati Yuvam Prattavan Ahamabhayam. And Vivasyam Manavipra, Vivasyam, the Sun God, because in the higher planetary system, this Sun planet, Moon planet, and many, many other planets, they are called the pagan planets. The inhabitants from those planets are very opulent. The material happiness available in those planets are hundreds and thousands times better than in this planet. So, it is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita that Sun planet is also inhabited by living beings. But their body is made of fire. That is different. Just like here, our body is made of earth. Earth, water, air, fire, ether, these are the five material elements. In some planet, the earth is prominent, in some planet, the water is prominent, in other planet, the fire is prominent. So this is the creation of God, different varieties. That is confirmed in the Bhagavad Gita. Atvaro humaitena kingyatena tabhadhana vishtyabhya idam krishnam etam sena sthuruya. This material world, composed of many billions of universes, that is one-fourth creation of the Supreme Personality of God. Ekamsena stutuvya. So, Bhagavad Gita means to understand what is God, the science of God. And God Himself is speaking about Himself. Otherwise, it is not possible to understand what is God. So if we carefully understand the slokas and the passages mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita, we can understand what is God. And the human form of life is meant for understanding God. He has no other business. The lower bodies, less than human form of body, according to Darwin's theory. The human form of body comes from monkey. But the evolution is accepted in the basic literature, but not like Darwin's. The evolution, according to basic scripture, is that the living entity is different from the world. And the living entity is passing through many forms of form. We shall read that. So, the bodies are according to my desire. I am desiring something. Just like here we are sitting, so many ladies and gentlemen, but not one of them is similar to anyone else. They are different bodies. That body is created according to one's desire. The mind, the subtle mind, is the creator of the next body. Janjama-bhati-smarana-bhavam-tadit-tante-kalevaram. At the time of death, whatever I am thinking, a similar body will be offered to me by the laws of nature, subtle mind. The mind, intelligence and ego, they are subtle body. And the gross body is made of earth, water, air, fire, etc. So, when we give up this gross body, the subtle body carries me to another gross body. This is the way of transmigration of the soul. The prakriti, nature's law is very strict and stringent. The nature will immediately offer you a similar body according to the thinking at the time of yourself. Prathadehantarapram. Therefore, this human form of body is meant for going back to home, back to God. Jadratyana nivatsante tadhamapatam. We are eternal. As God is eternal, we are also eternal. Because we are part and parcel of God. As God is always blissful, jolly, similarly, our nature is always blissful and young. Satchidananda Vigraha. Sat Chit Ananda. Sat means Siddhananda. And Chit means full of knowledge. And Ananda. Ananda means blissfulness. That is our nature. Therefore, we want to live. We do not wish to die. You do not wish to, nobody wishes to die, but you are forced to death. That is our punishment. Nitya sāsatayam nahnate hannamāne sarīre. This instruction is given to our Gita. That the living entity is eternal. Sāsatayam, very, very old. Nitya sāsatayam nahnate hannamāne sarīre. When the body is destroyed, is annihilated, the soul exists, it goes to another body. The example is described every one of us in the first day of intercourse of the father and mother. The secrets are mixed together, emulsified, and in the living entity, is allowed to enter into that, it grows. That is the beginning of our body. But if the living entity is not allowed into the that emulsified small pea-like ball, then there is no presence. So attempt is made to follow that emulsification. Therefore, the living entity cannot enter into it, and there is no presence. Otherwise, there must be pregnancy. Then that pea-like body grows, and in 7 months, it grows the hands and legs and heads and everything. And consciousness comes back. When we die, our consciousness becomes almost stopped, and we lie down within the womb of the mother, according to species of body, take it for granted our human form of body. 7 months, at that time body is grown up. And this way, in 10th month, the body is fully grown, then by nature's way, the body comes out and another life begins. This is called transmigration of the soul. So, actually, we are eternal. In the Vedic language, it is said, nitya nityanam cetana cetananam ekonjo bahunam vidadati kaman. Nitya. Nitya means eternal. And nityanam. Nityanam means plural number of nityas. So there are many nityas, many living entities. But there is one nitya, supreme, that is God. He is also a living entity like us. Then what is the difference? The difference is, we learn from the Greek dance, eto-bhavanam-vidadhati-kama. The similar number nitya, eternal, maintains the plural number of nitya. We are within the plural number, nityana. So, the conclusion is, the God is the Supreme Being and we are living being. So our relation is very intimate. Qualitatively, we are one. Because we are part and parcel. So, God is eternal, full of knowledge and blissful. Therefore, our position is also the same, but in minute quantity. His knowledge is great. Therefore, God is great. Our knowledge is limited. And because we have got limited potencies, therefore we are called living entities. And God has got unlimited potencies, therefore God is great and we are small. This is the conclusion of the Bhagavad Gita. And we are in this material world, being contaminated by the material nature. We are suffering because anything material, it has got limited period of existence. Anything is there. It is asar. Asar means which will not exist. And short means which will exist. The basic intention is asatoma, sattama. You are sat. You will revive your eternal life. Don't be entangled in this asar. So we are transmigrating from one body to another. There is evolution. Jalavāna lakthāni sthāvara lakthāni sthāti kīmāya uruddha sankhata bhakṣināma dasa lakthakam. Because in the beginning the whole planet was covered in water. The water is drying up and gradually land is coming out. So therefore, in the beginning, the aquatics, jalajāna lakthāni. So, the aquatic animals, there are 900,000 species. Jalajāna sthāvara lakthāni śruti. Then trees and plants and herbs and grasses and so many. They are 2 million more. Then kīmāya uruddha sankhata. Then insect life, reptile life, 1,100,000. Then pakshinam dasalakhama. Then birds, varieties of birds, 1 million. that Osu, four-legged animals, 3 million times, that Manusasatur Lukhani, then human form of life, uncivilized and civilized, that human form of life, 400,000. So, in comparison to the lower species of life, we are very small ones. Together, there are 8,400,000 species of life, living entity. The evolution process is from one body to another. In this way, when it comes to the human form of life, it should be utilized for full knowledge about our eternal life. That is the opportunity. And if you don't take this opportunity, you will live like other animals, eating, sleeping, sex, and fearful life. Ahara nidra bhaya. But you do not care to understand what we are, what is God, what is our relationship with God, then you are missing the point. That lesson, instruction, is given in the Bhagavad Gita. And it is very easy to understand the perplexity which Arjuna met at the battlefield of Kurukshetra. The fight was between two sectors of family members, the cousin brothers, one family. But there was some trouble who would occupy the throne. From Mahabharata we understand that the Pandavas, at least after Maharaj Parikshit, he ruled over the whole world. Bhagavatam means the whole world. And the capital was here, Hastinapur. This information we get Mahabharata. Maha means greater and Bharat means India. Mahabharata. So there was trouble who will occupy the throne. So there was fight. So when fight was arranged, then Arjuna, he was a devotee of Krishna. He declared to fight. He said to Krishna, "My dear Krishna, Krishna is great. I don't like this fight because they are my cousin brothers. Although they have usurped my kingdom, let them enjoy it. I don't need to fight with them." But Krishna declined. Krishna said, "No, you have to fight. Your duty is to fight." Then Arjuna placed before him so many ideas that if I kill my brother, then my brother's wife will be widow, and they may be polluted. Then unwanted children, Varnasankar will come out, and when the Varnasankar population is filling, then the whole world becomes a hell. So many arguments. So Krishna, when he saw that Arjuna is very much afflicted with the material ideas, so he wanted to teach him the Bhagavad Gita. So first punishment, not punishment, chastisement, because Arjuna accepted that the complexities which I am facing is not possible to be solved except yourself. He knew that Krishna is the Supreme Personality of God. So he surrendered himself to Krishna. Krishna Sriham Sadhimam Pramannam Tampanjan Dusu Apohatas Sabhava. I am a Kshatriya. It is my duty to fight in right cases. And I am declined. This is my weakness. So kindly instruct me how I can give up this weak leg. I am accepting you as my guru. Shishasti, hum. Shisha means who voluntarily accepts to be ruled by a person who is guru. This is called Shisha. So, Arjuna and Krishna, they were friends, but still, to take right instruction without any argument, he accepted his guru. Then, after the acceptance, Krishna's first warning is, asajjānam sūtastam pragyāmādāṁ suhāsas tatāsum avatāsum sa nāna sūtam vipandhika. My dear Arjuna, you are talking like a very learned man. But the subject matter which is touched is not at all taken seriously by the Pandit. Pandit means learned man. That means you are talking like a fool. You are taking this body as self. So, actually this is not the fact. The body is not the self. The self is different. If you analyze this body, what you will find? Suppose we are breathing. What is this breathing? It is air only. Now, when the breathing is stopped, a man is dead. Now you are so much advanced in science. Why don't you replace this breathing? It is nothing but air. So, you can manufacture some machine working in electric battery and put some air and fix up. And then the same air will come. Host, 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 host. Will that give you life? No. Even if you artificially bring breathing, just like nowadays they put oxygen gas, as if oxygen gas is life. That is not the fact. So if you analyze every part of the body, then you find that there is no life. This is not education, this is not scientific knowledge. Simply abruptly taking something without any proper understanding, that is not knowledge. Therefore, Krishna chastised him that you are talking like a very scientific learned scholar, but you are a fool number one. Because you are accepting this material body as the self. This is ignorance. This is a confront in another place. Jashat buddhi punape siddhāti. This punape, this bag of three elements come up with the life. All take it. The skin, muscle, veins, bone, urine, stool, blood, what do you find if you dissect this body? They are all material things. What is blood? It is also water, rainwater. The urine, this is also water. And this bone is nothing but earth, hardened. If you take plaster of Paris, they sometimes show artificial bone also in the medical college. But that is bone, that is art. So do you think that combination of this art, water, air, fire is life? Can you produce life? You can get enough art, water, air, fire, stool, urine, blood to manufacture one life. That you cannot do. This is called analysis. And those who are engaged in understanding the self as the combination of these art, water, air, fire, Saiva Gokara, such persons are defined in the Shastra as no more intelligent than the cows and the asses. So, from here, spiritual knowledge begins. You analyze the body, but you won't find the real soul or real life, although it is within you. But why you cannot find? It is very, very small. Isha-kri-sadabhāvasya-sadabhāvasya-sadabhāvasya-sadabhāvasya-sadabhāvasya-sadabhāvasya. The formation of the soul, measurement of the soul, is very, very, it is smaller than the atom. Isha-kri-sadabhāvasya. The tip of the hair is divided into 100 parts. And take one part, again divide it into 100 parts. That one part is the measurement of the soul. That means 1/10,000 part of the top of the head. So you can see, that small particle is giving you living soul. This knowledge we get from Bhagavad Gita, and that is the fact. You cannot get light by analyzing this material body, that is not possible. You have to find out what is that small particle. You have to hear. Therefore, you cannot get knowledge by your material activities. You have to hear it from the authority. Otherwise there is no possibility. That's why you cannot understand who is your father. You have to take the knowledge from your mother. If mother certifies, this gentleman is your father. That is correct. But if you go on researching who is your father, you will never be able to know who is your father. Similarly, what is life, what is soul, what is heart, this body, what is the ultimate goal of life, why you are suffering, all this knowledge you have to take from the higher authorities. That is called Vedic process. Not to endeavor by research. What you can research? Our fund of knowledge is very, very poor, limited. He cannot have perfect knowledge unless he hears from the authority. So Krishna is the authority. Our Krishna consciousness movement means you get knowledge from the best authority. Don't manufacture knowledge, that is not it. That is Krishna consciousness movement. But here Krishna says that, my dear Arjuna, you are talking like a very common man. That is our disease. Everyone we talk as if we manufacture, and that is useless. Hiyami, Tanamari, Dabhavi, you cannot make any solution. Because the whole world is in chaotic condition. We speak of our own country, India, not only India. Everywhere, the chaotic condition is because they have no real knowledge. That simply claiming to be very learned man, which is disguised here like Krishna. Asuchyavansuchastam prajnava. You are presenting yourself as very learned man. But this subject matter which you are telling, this body is nothing but dead lump of man. That is it. But here, that asuchyavansuchastam dadasam apadasamstha. This body, when it is living condition, living condition means so long the soul is there. It looks like very bright, little hole moving here and there. And when the soul leaves this body, tell me what it is. It has no value. A lump of matter. Just like a motor car. So long it is moving, it is worth 1 lakh. And so long it does not move, it is simply lump of iron and copper and something. Who cares for it? It is stone. Same thing. The body has no value. It has value so long the soul is there. Otherwise, suppose a big man, say, lamenting, such a great man has passed away. Well, what is that such a great man? He is lying on the floor of the bed, the same man. So why you are saying that he has gone? Then who has gone? You have never seen him who has gone. This is ignorance. Dāpari paritajyāyāṁ. In the Satya Yuga, when the duration of life was very, very great, meditation was possible. And next Yuga, teaching of Gharu Vishnu, Sitana Vajato Makhari. By performing the ritualistic ceremonies recommended in the Vedas, Yoga. And the next Yuga, by Parichatya, by Vidhivas, and next to God is Kali Yuga, Hari Kirtana, simply by chanting the holy name of the Lord. Otherwise, and meditation means Kritika Dhyana Vishnu. Meditation means to think of Vishnu, Lord Vishnu. That is the recommendation. Dhyana Rastita Tadvate Namana Sāpat Santijan Yogi. The yogi, they think of the Supreme Person, Dhyanavastita, Manasa, mind absorbed, surcharged in thinking of Vishnu. That is called meditation. Dhyanavastita Padgatena Manasa, Pashanti Samjuri. And in the Bhagavad Gita, this hand is recommended in the 6th chapter. Jyotinavati Sarvesa, Madhagata Antaratmana. Sadhyavan, Vajati Joma, Sanin Juktakam. Any yogi, there are different varieties of yogi. There are all the yogis. The Bhakta yogi who is thinking of Krishna is in the mind. He is the first class yogi. So, in our movement, we are creating first class yogis. Because they are chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama. So, you see, directly to create first class yogi, yogi nama of this
generation. Swamiji, in our ancient books, Krishna has also been projected as a person who has lived to a certain period of history and who was associated with a number of
activities
during his contemporary time. Our books of literature also projects him as the supreme being, as the perfect one. How do you reconcile the two facts? How do we accept that your teachings are based on the assumption that that person who lived to that period of time is the perfect one? But how do you fundamentally assume that what he has said is correct? How do you reconcile the two points?
That I have already explained, that one has to understand Krishna, janma karma nirvikram, jo janati tat. Before your asking, I have already explained that he, that person, Krishna, whom you think that he lived for a certain period with friends and relatives, just like ordinary man. If you simply study what is this person, then you become a janma karma some wisdom to jana adhikar. To understand him, in fact, it is not so easy. That is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Manusaram sarvasehu kaschid jatati siddhare jatatana visidhyana kaschid vetimam kapat. Out of many millions of persons, one becomes siddha, perfect. So that perfection is not complete perfection. That perfection means all compassion. I am not this material body, I am spirit soul. So, one who understands this position of oneself is calculated as perfect. But, jatatam visidhyana, in that perfect state, if one endeavor to understand Krishna, jatatam visidhyana, kunti, out of many such millions of persons who try to understand Krishna in perfection, one million. So it is not so easy. Janma karma also may be bound. These are again separate. But that factual understanding is possible. How is it possible? Bhaktyamaravadi, Jalaradastam, Sattva. Only through devotion you can understand. So these problems you will solve when you become a devotee. Then Krishna is revealed. Atasya Krishna Namadi Navade Prayam Indian. If you try to understand that Supreme Person, Krishna, who comes before you as a person, you can understand him if you become his devotee. Otherwise, it is not possible. Atasya Krishna Namadi. You cannot understand Krishna, his name, his form, his pastimes, his activities. None of it, I am, really, by your imperfect senses. But Sevamukhehi Jivaro, Samayamas, when you are engaged in his service, then he will use it. Here I am. So this is the process. If you want to understand that person, Krishna, who is accepted as the Supreme Personality of Godhead, then you have to take shelter of Bhakti Guru and associate with Bhakta, then it is possible. Otherwise, not. Pranam Swami.
Hare Krishna. Gandhiji was also the great admirer of the Gita and the great scholar of Krishna, big commentary also. But he, at the time of the great power, asked the great powers to let Hitler come in and not fight him at all. But whereas he said that it was the change of heart that should be rejected and not that punishment. That means punishment against the power. And you would like your enlightenment on this paradox.
The punishment Krishna does not personally punish. He has got many agents, just like the government. The president does not punish by the king, but there are many departments. Similarly, Parasa Shakti Bhutarasya being, his potencies are manifold. One of the potencies is this material nature. It is called Maya, that is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Daini Tisha Gunamai Mama Maya Bhagavad. It is very difficult to surpass the jurisdiction of Maya, Bhagavad. But punishment is not excuse. Ignorance of law is no excuse. Similarly, this Maya, this material nature is very, very strong. If you eat little more, your nature is to eat, say, 2 hours. If you eat 3 hours, immediately you will become very big like this. The nature is so strong. Therefore, it is called the Vichisadhanamai Manavayadhu. So in this way, you cannot surpass the stringent laws of Maya. But if you want to avoid punishment, then you take shelter of Krishna. Mani prapadyante mayami tam karanti. Therefore, Krishna consciousness is essential. If you become Krishna conscious, if you follow the instruction of Krishna, then there is no question of being harassed by the stringent laws of Maya. This is the problem.